What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you all so much for tuning in to this, another house show production in association with Pro Wrestling Ego. My name is Corey. To my right,
this is Joe.
And we are here for the wonderful outing that our very own Ray Fury has put together. Joe, why don't you tell us a little bit about what we're doing tonight?
What we're doing tonight is the United for Puerto Rico fundraiser. With all of the things that have been going on, multiple hurricanes hitting Puerto Rico.
Right.
They are still suffering heavily down there. So much infrastructure is down, and a lot of support is needed. And it's been great to see all of the wrestling fans who are out there who have been tweeting support, have donated some, have shown support by raising awareness, and we're just really grateful for that. And that's what this event is for, is to raise money that we can all send off but to Puerto Rico for support there.
That's right. 100% of the proceeds that are made tonight are going out to Puerto Rico. And so thank you, Ray Fury, for throwing this together, and we hope that this finds the people of Puerto Rico and helps them out in the ways that they so desperately need. But for right now, we're going to call a little bit of wrestling right here at the Hideaway in Jackson, Mississippi.
Any stipulation they want. So pretty much their imagination can run wild, yes. So, like I said, on a personal note, I thank all of y'all. I am doing better. My words are a little slow, but they're getting better. So, thank y'all all for coming out.
It's always good to see Scott back, and all the best wishes for him. Glad he's back in the ring.
Our first match. All right, our first match of the evening, ladies and gentlemen, is a 10-minute time limit. Ooh. Mr. Dave is awesome. Y'all want to start a chant for Mr. Dave real quick? Thank you, Dave.
Thank you, Dave. He's a good ref. I'm not gonna take it away from him.
You're invincible. All right, our first participant, ladies and gentlemen, is from Cecilia, Louisiana. This is Braxton Hunter.
Braxton Hunter, as Scott so succinctly put it, from Louisiana. First time I've actually seen this guy wrestle, so I'm looking forward to this tonight.
He's making his way around the ring with a good bit of energy. He's out there getting in touch with his fans right now.
As a good wrestler should.
In a good touch, not in like bad touch or anything.
No, never a bad touch here at Pro Wrestling Ego.
We don't need that.
No, thank you. Young kid, clean cut. Seems to have the audience's support for now. He's going to be fighting Nick Dark Horse Marcos here tonight.
It might be hard to pick a favorite in a match like this, since this is sort of from some of the first times we're seeing some of these guys. But when one guy labels himself the Dark Horse, you kind of got to feel like... Gotta feel like Braxton's got a halfway decent shot here.
And maybe a chip on his shoulder. We'll have to wait and see.
From Kenner, Louisiana.
Two Louisiana boys tonight.
Marcos.
Nick, flashy looking. Dark horse on the pants.
It would appear that he is ready for war of some kind.
But honestly, Joe, what is it good
either
for?
Either war or absolutely nothing.
I hear you. Hunter warming up in the corner. Braxton trying to get the audience behind him.
And at this point, we must be waiting for this verse to end.
Well, you know, you gotta follow through with it.
Gotta get the rhythm with it. I mean, we're back to the AA and BB that you've got to, right. You know, like good poetry has.
Absolutely.
You gotta wait for the conclusion, or it'd be very unsatisfying.
And here we go. Hunter to the center with Marcos.
Dave calls
offering
the
hands.
Bell.
A good handshake between them.
Aww.
And here we go. Did you just aw?
Like, that's like my least favorite noise. Aw.
Was like he's a kitten? What the hell is that?
He is kind of. He's a shiny little kitten. Look at him.
I'll take it. A little rolling around here in the corner. Let's see if we get a clean break from Marcos.
Eventually.
There we go.
And there it
there
is.
There we go. Nice and sportsmanship. A little pat on the chest. A little attaboy. Marcos seems to be showing his colors a little bit.
I mean, there's so much encouragement. You got to feel like there's a little bit of sarcasm with it. Locking up again. Hunter with the headlock here.
Getting nice and deep into that headlock. Marcos slipping out of it fairly easy and returning the favor. Both men down to one knee.
A lot of good technique that we're seeing right here.
Warming up, feeling each other out, and quickly to the hip toss right onto the mat.
A lot of the grind here at the beginning.
Ref checking those shoulders, doing what he does best. Hunter trying to get him off in there.
Arching the back to no avail, but he locks him up with the legs and brings him back down and reverses the maneuver.
Oh, and a quick bridge over for the one count. Marcos staying on him.
Marcos definitely with a size advantage here. Let's see if he can actually leverage that a little bit into putting Hunter where he wants him.
Absolutely. Marcos just wrenching in on that arm. Hunter with the counter, bringing him right over. Coming in, Marcos with the back. Hunter down and around with the reversal. Marcos just flipping him over. Spin, drop kick pushed away by Marcos. He's not having any of that tonight.
Emphatically on a certain level. I think his patience is starting to wear down. We've had a lot of collegiality up until now, but I think we're finally starting to get into the meat here of this is a contest and somebody's got to win.
Absolutely. Circling each other.
Dark Horse has got some fans in the crowd there.
Knee to the midsection.
Oh, nice slap.
Heard that all the way up here on the balcony. Quick elbow to the chin. Dropping him down to the floor. Marcos hammering away.
Taking it for the ride.
Send him off into the corner. Follow up with the clothesline. Marcos making his own calls in the middle of the ring. Those usually don't work out too well.
Yeah, I think he telegraphed a little bit too much, not only physically but audibly. And Hunter's able to put on a reversal and flip him over.
Nice.
For the pin, kick out. Our referee Dave taking a little bump right there. Look out for yourself, Dave. You got a long night ahead of you.
You know, it's not a good match until the ref gets in on it. So, why not? If Dave's feeling froggy, I'm going to let him do it. He's been around for a while. Into the corner with a splash and an elbow.
There might be still a little bit of pepper in that salt on top of his head. He might still be able to get a good couple bumps in.
Anything's possible, man. I guarantee Dave can take more bumps than we can.
yeah.
And by more, I mean one. Because we can't even do that.
I got to go down at the end.
Hunter with a leapfrog, hip toss to the mat. Marcos feeling that one in the lower back. Sends him off with a high knee. This Hunter kid's got some good elevation to him.
Kick out at two. It's going to take a little bit more than that to wear down the Dark Horse. Hunter's got him back into the corner now. Goes to send him off. Reversal.
Oh, and a quick backbreaker.
Marcos has got him where he wants him right now.
You think Marcos couldn't afford the royalties for Katy Perry's Dark Horse? That's why he went with War?
I wouldn't imagine that War was any cheaper, really. I mean,
that's very true.
Katy needs the money?
I don't think she does. She may say different. Marcos sits the man. Going for the suplex.
I'm not sure that Katy Perry's
into a fisherman right to the back.
I'm sure that Katy Perry's song would really set the right tone for Marcos here.
It might not, but damned if it doesn't tie in well. Hunter in the corner, getting Marcos off.
When the beat drops, would be a good time to come down the stairs, though.
Oh, man, that'd be great. Yeah, we got to try that sometime. Hunter up with the missile drop kick from the second rope.
Seems to be favoring that forearm.
Absolutely.
Over on the side. I may have done more damage to himself than he did to Marcos.
It's possible. Hunter taking a breath. Marcos shaking it off. Dave checking on both. Marcos coming in. Ref checking on him. Dave, we good? No.
It's not looking good for Braxton Hunter right now.
Mm-mm. Marcos giving him some time.
Dave's going to call it right now.
Ringing the bell. That is a shame to see. All right. Well, Marcos, our winner. The Dark Horse is the winner tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner.
Looks like Hunter may have done something to his wrist, the way he's holding it.
Yeah, his right wrist. His fingers don't seem to be moving very well. Definitely taking a lot out of him. It's sad to see that happen to Braxton Hunter.
Absolutely.
Yeah, a good match going there. Sorry for Dark Horse even.
Yep, absolutely.
It was a good contest going. We had a good flow. But your winner, Dark Horse Marcos.
Yep. Hopefully we'll see Nick Marcos here again. And for that matter, hopefully we see Braxton Hunter here
again.
That's
right. Hopefully we'll get some good word on him after a little while.
Cowboy Scott making his way back in. Once again, folks, let's introduce ourselves. If you've never heard of us, if you found us by accident on YouTube, we are part of the House Show podcast right out of here of Jackson, Mississippi. Myself, Corey, you can find me at @HouseShow_Corey on Twitter.
You can find me on Twitter at @HouseShow_Joe, where we will get commentary from us. Much more than you want to, really.
Pretty much. You can also find our main account at House Show Pod on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And our main account, our main podcast, can be found at anchor.fm/House Show Pod.
And if you look really carefully, you can find us on iTunes.
Yeah, absolutely. We're there. It kind of shuffles it out to iTunes from Anchor.
That's right. But you can get a lot more stuff happening on Anchor, daily updates, and our Four Corner segments end up there.
And you can even call in. You can comment into the feed almost as if it were Twitter. And we're pretty good about answering some questions and keeping up to date on that. So definitely hit us up. Merchandise coming soon. We got some merchandise on the line. We'll try and get that out pretty soon. So you never know what's going to happen.
And to keep up with information on Pro Wrestling Ego, you can always check out the hashtag that they've got for Pro Wrestling Ego. And you find them on Twitter at
Pro Wrestling Ego.
You can also find them on Facebook and Instagram.
Anywhere your Pro Wrestling Ego is around, you're going to find them. We got a tag team match coming up right now. The Cavemen are going to be putting their belts, I believe, on the line. We've seen Silva before. Silva tonight is teaming up with Zombie Dragon.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is for our Pro Wrestling Ego Tag Team Titles.
There it is. Cowboy Scott says it. It's got to be true. Zombie Dragon up in the rafters over here.
Trying to light our balcony on fire.
Let's hope he doesn't. We got too much I don't think the Hideaway would care for that too much. Well, there's the fire, though. Making his way down the ramp. His book is on fire. His face and chest are streaked with blood.
Together they are the left hand back. Eric the Ghost Silva and Zombie Dragon.
The Ghost and the Dragon tonight. Zombie Dragon, one of those guys you definitely don't want to get too close to because you never know what's going to happen with him. Silva making his way in.
Fellas with their slithery entrance.
We are joined by a close personal friend. Boot Boy Bubbler is here tonight. Good to see you, brother. So we had a bit of a problem with that first match. Everything going to be all right?
Yeah, well, that's part of the business, man. This is a rough sport. This isn't ballet. People get hurt.
That's the truth.
Every time we walk in there, something like that can happen.
Yeah, very true indeed. Well, we're glad to have you here.
Glad to be here. I'm interested in this match coming up.
That's the way you should be.
Their opponents and the tag team champions.
Here come the cavemen. Now, Bubbler, you've had some run-ins with the cavemen. In fact, unfortunately, you and Chuck dropped the belts to the cavemen. When are we going to see you guys face off again?
Well, hopefully real soon. We're going to see what happens tonight. They're facing a tough team, a very seasoned team. They're a young tag team. They just started, you know, they just broke in the business.
Absolutely.
But with that being said, they're really good. I mean, they got the victory on
right.
Chuck and Shaky. We can't deny it. They won fair and square. We're looking forward to getting back into that title picture, and they have what we want. So we're gonna see how tonight goes, and we're just going to make our next move there.
Absolutely. Well, we're glad to have you. And always good to see you guys in the ring.
Glad to be seen.
Hashtag protein and Pop-Tarts. Those Pop-Tarts are getting the better of you, brother. You gotta hey, switch that around.
I'll tell you what, man. You gotta ration out the protein for the Pop-Tarts.
Yep.
Gotta find that ration.
Of course, you put them both together, and you just end up with Hot Pockets.
There you go.
Yeah.
Nobody wants that.
Nobody really wants that, really. No.
Tell you what, cavemen are ready to go tonight. They got a little fire.
Speaking of fire, Zombie Dragon's got the fire in his wrist. They need to watch out for that one.
Yeah. Wes Warren's actually felt it before.
Yes, he has.
Okay,
hang on.
Feeling something right there.
Well,
that is Nightmare.
Nightmare is back, bringing these boys down. There goes Wes up. Oh, good Lord. And as quick as he made his way in, he's back onto the outside.
This ain't good.
We haven't seen Nightmare in a good while, and he looks like he's hungry. He's here to eat up some cavemen.
Come on, man. He don't need to be doing this.
Nightmare got him up.
Got him up.
And dropping. Right back down. Good Lord.
Looks like we're going to have more casualties here tonight.
Zombie and Silva don't even have to do anything. They're just hanging out on the outside. Wes trying to protect his brother. That's not going to work out well.
Oh, man.
Dave's got to get some type of control in there. Not that anybody can really control the Nightmare.
I don't know what alliance Nightmare has with Zombie Dragon and Silva, but this don't look good for Ego.
Looks like Nightmare's made his point. Stepping back for a moment. Silva and Zombie Dragon have a bit of a conference on the outside.
Now they want
to
pick
up the
bones.
Inside.
Of course, ring the bell now.
Yeah. Dave doing his job, checking on the guys first and foremost.
And he presents signals for the bell.
There goes the bell. Quick two count.
You know, if you can't pin a man who's just been taken down by Nightmare, what are you doing in this ring?
Silva trying again on any man. There's no precedence right now. We don't even know who's the legit guy in. There's the two count.
Dave's reluctant to call this pin right now. He wants to give these cavemen a chance at least.
I'll tell you what, though. These cavemen got heart. They're going to fight to the very end. They're hurting now, but they will fight.
Nightmare still lurking around the outside of the ring. We may be seeing their actual hearts. He's still lurking.
Silva taking it over there to Wes. Wes struggling to get up. Silva's going to give him a hand. Quick blows to the stomach and a knee in return. Back and forth. Wes is trying to answer every single call. Wes off the ropes. Silva just simply raises that leg. Chop to the and a kick.
This may be it.
He's keeping all those shots high. Dave was warning him about that.
Zombie coming off. Double leg drop and a swanton. Good heavens.
I don't know how much more this kid's going to be able to take.
He shouldn't have had to take any of this to begin with. Thanks to Nightmare, though, that's a completely different situation.
Zombie Dragon cinching it in.
Up and for a down neck breaker. With a neck breaker.
He's very unorthodox, but a very good wrestler.
Coming in, no. Come on. Dave's trying to keep it kosher in here. You're hurting your partner there, brother. There we go. And he's off.
A lot of times I've been in that situation. You just want to get in and help your buddy so bad.
Absolutely.
That it becomes a deterrent from the ref and it gives your team advantage, just like right now.
Well, you let your heart get ahead of your head.
You got to keep your head in the game sometimes. You can't let your heart get all over yourself.
Wes getting choked out with that wrist wrap. Dave, thankfully, getting in the middle of there. Nightmare slapping Wes.
This is getting out of control.
Wes is on the outside. Zombie Dragon in. Quick shoulder block. Wes up and over. Off the rope. And a high, high kick from Zombie Dragon. Wes gets him off on a two count.
I'm still trying to figure out how Silvio and Zombie Dragon, who they sold their soul to get Nightmare hanging
get Nightmare
around
involved.
Outside for them.
Yeah.
On their side. Not sure what's happening there.
Tag being made. The Ghost coming in. I mean, they're smart. They've got Wes in the opposite corner. They're keeping on him. No chance for anybody else to get any action in. Silva's got him. Two count.
Yeah, a lot of people don't understand. You can't just look at them as monsters. These guys are smart cookies. They know what they're doing.
Absolutely. Wes favoring the back of that left leg.
And I know Wes has got a lot of heart, but this is that place where that heart gets in the way. There's some wisdom into, just laying down so you can actually fight another day.
Right, but they love holding those tag titles, man.
When belts on the line, anything goes, and you want to make sure those straps stay with you. Nightmare just circling the ring like a shark waiting for more blood. Dragon involved when he shouldn't be. Cowboy Scott keeping far away from Nightmare. Wise man.
There's your chest, Wes. Come on.
Wes is off. Grabbed by the back of the tights there. Into the buckles. Trust me, folks, there's not a lot of padding in those things.
No, that's
you got
not
nothing
a pillow.
But steel behind it.
Not a pillow.
Silva with the two count.
Wes kicks out again. He is not staying down.
A lot of heart on Wes Warren.
Yep. Wes calling for some support from the audience. Dragon telling him to be quiet. Bubbler, have you ever heard Dragon actually speak?
No, I don't think I want to.
Be something like those Nazguls on Lord of the Rings, just a high-pitched screech. Both men down in the middle.
I have a feeling he might sound like a mean girl.
Rev needs to watch Nightmare.
Yeah, absolutely.
Come on, Wes. Here's your chance. Got to get to your partner.
Wes reaching up. Trying to get that hot tag. Slowly going in. Silva reaching for Dragon, and the tag is made. Coming in hot. Dragon down, and Silva. Nice axe chop. Around the back. Quick elbows. Oh, my Lord. Super kick right to the chin. Pandemonium in the ring right now. Up, down. Oh, and a quick straight to the face.
Holding on to, holding on to Dave.
And there's the three count.
The three count.
Ladies and gentlemen, Zombie Dragon and Silva.
No, no bell.
Well, they may have been slow on the bell, but that's honestly. There was a three count in the middle. Nightmare's coming in.
Everybody, I think, is a little confused about this.
Yeah, because it looked like, it looked like Dave waved it off.
Do you think the caveman had him spray to
Wes
the face?
Being thrown into the corner there.
Oh, man, this can't. Come on, man.
Nightmare off the ropes.
I'm not happy these kids beat us, but I don't want them to go through this.
Nightmare with the power bomb.
Bringing them back up.
Come on, there's no excuse for all this.
Something's got to be done about this group.
Jeremiah's got them up. Oh, good heavens. And a tombstone right into the middle of the floor. Good heavens.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winners.
Come on, that's it.
And new tag team champions.
That
there
is
it is.
It.
Silva and Dragon are the new tag champions for Pro Wrestling Ego. Bubbler, looks like you got some new competition.
I'm just going to say this. Something's got to be done about this group right now, or this is going to get really bad.
Absolutely.
Guys, thank you.
Thank you, Bubbler, for coming in. You're welcome anytime.
Thanks, guys.
Just can't believe what we're watching right now. Zombie Dragon is holding that belt up with Silvio. Ref Davis attending to Alex right now, while with Cowboy Scott. Zombie Dragon with that that flame, that flash right to his eyes right there.
Good heavens. If these
Wes
guys
is
have
out
got
on the ground.
If these guys have got the straps, then there's going to be a lot of chaos coming our way real soon, especially with the nightmare associated with them now.
Yeah, this is... this is a combination of forces that Pro Wrestling Ego has not seen. That is a lot of dark force right there in the ring. Your new tag team champions, Zombie Dragon.
Here's what I want to know.
Ghost Silvio.
Where is Jacob Lockhart? Jacob's been the only guy I've ever seen that have been able to contain Nightmare to any extent.
Well, I would say the last time we saw Nightmare was when he broke free from Jacob Lockhart.
Yep, and he went off
that chain
somewhere.
And he has not been around since. We've not seen Jacob Lockhart at all.
Right.
And now Nightmare has no control on him. Because you know Zombie Dragon and Silvio, they're not going to be containing Nightmare at all.
No.
It's dangerous times in the tag team division of Pro Wrestling Ego. Looks like Wes has got some help and trying to clean up the carnage down here. We have more of a show to come.
Yeah. I mean, for the first two matches of the night, good heavens, we've had injuries galore. All right. Scott talking to some people. Audience not really sure which way this is going. Caveman being helped back to the back.
That was kind of a
audience calling for a rematch. It's a little soon. This just went down.
I have a feeling if they were to rematch right now, the outcome would still not be any different.
Yep, outcome would still be the same.
Now's the time to show a little bit of wisdom, go back, heal up, lick some wounds.
Yep, absolutely.
Get better and get ready. It's tough to prepare for a team like Zombie Dragon and Sylvia when all of a sudden Nightmare shows up.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a whole nother level that you were not prepared for.
Yeah, Jeremiah is not one to mess with. Just the sheer size of that guy.
I'm not surprised. He doesn't care, so I'll get some. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're getting close to our intermission.
Dave making his way back into the ring. We've got one more match till intermission. And little did we expect it. When you hear Faith No More, you got a feeling that Barry Wolf, Lucas Frost, probably even Monty are somewhere nearby. And sure enough, making their way down, Lucas Frost and Barry Wolf. I guess we should count our blessings that Monty Warbucks isn't here.
I don't know why you have to be like that. I mean,
I don't know why he has to be like that.
Lucas!
He is a man who likes to tell the truth.
You want to know what's the
cold,
truth?
Hard truth.
Lucas Frost's beard is amazing.
That's the truth. There is literally no arguing with that. That is a phenomenal beard. And it is here to have the truth spoken through it. To reach us, to tell us the way that it really is.
You know, there's always one bad one in the batch, and unfortunately you had to be that, Joe.
I'm the whole batch, son.
You know what? You're probably right on that one.
Lucas Frost helping Cowboy Scott fix his hat a little bit, get the right angle.
Yeah, absolutely. He's a helper. That's what they always say about Lucas Frost.
That's what his Enneagram type is.
Look here, Dukes of Hazzard. We go through this.
He's a giver.
Time. If you're going to announce us, you announce us properly.
Barry Wolf has the mic. Means we're going to be here for a while.
I can't understand what you're saying. When you address this man, you address him like this. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing one half of the experience from Seattle, Washington. He is Lucas Frost.
I mean, that was better.
Shut your mouth.
Arguably, yeah.
And then you people stand up. Hey.
You know, he's being very helpful here. I mean, some people don't know how to attend a Pro Wrestling Ego show. So this is a paint-by-numbers version. You know, this is a fundraiser. A lot of people are here to support the efforts to raise money for Puerto Rico, and that's why they're here. But they may not, they may not know how to treat the experience properly.
Well, here's one way to treat them. When you
speaking of not knowing how to treat the experience.
Here comes Bubbler. Here comes Shaky. Here comes Chuck. The Abbey Street Boot Boys.
Barry and Lucas didn't even have a chance to say why they were here. You don't even have anything to argue with at this point.
Why do I need to argue about the Boot Boys?
I'm saying the Boot Boys are out here earlier. They don't have anything to argue with. What are they here for?
I think they're probably going to have a conversation with the experience.
They didn't hear what the experience had to say. They don't even know what they're conversing about. But that's what the Boot Boys do.
You know what? You're absolutely right, Joe. You're absolutely right. How
I'm
can
sorry,
I debate
that? I was done
that.
Listening to you for a second.
What else is new? You haven't listened to me in a while.
I'm sorry, what?
Check you, Farley. Chuck Chuck running around like a wild man, and he's gassed.
He's
already
gassed. This is over.
He's gassed. Forget it. Chuck is out. Put Bubbler, put Shaky in there. Where is Bubbler? Where is Shaky?
I don't know. They
Where
left.
The hell did they go?
They went back upstairs.
All right. Well, listen. You got to do what you got to do.
They just delivered Chuck down there.
They said, you know what? You got it. Go for it, Chuck. And he will. Chuck's got it. Chuck seems to have something on his mind.
I'm not 100% sure, but I do believe that Chuck is calling one of them bald.
Chuck is calling Lucas Frost out.
How we doing, fellas?
Well, what's happening, Shaky? You want to get on the mic?
Sure, why not?
Come on.
There you go. I figured I'd stand over here and watch my little big brother.
Right on.
Wrestle.
Now, this is completely unexpected. We've got Chuck going against Lucas Frost. What brought this on, Shaky?
Well, you know, we've had a bit of a program with the experience for a Absolutely. Little while, and yeah, it was bound to happen again.
I would imagine so. Chuck's never wanted to back away from a fight, as are both of you and Bubbler, so this should be good on Chuck checking Dave, make sure Dave's got nothing for him.
As he does.
And Dave is a little ticklish. We all knew that.
I'm starting to believe Chuck is very paranoid. Not starting. I've always believed he's...
Oh, I was about to say, you've known him for how long now?
All of his life.
Exactly.
All of my life. Boot Boys established 1985.
There it is. Shaky, what are your thoughts on... Now we've got Silva and Dragon Zombie, or Zombie Dragon, pardon me, now holding the straps.
Well, I'm a little concerned.
That's what you should be.
Because I overheard Bubbler when he was over here, and I agree. Those are our belts.
Absolutely.
Those are ours.
Yeah.
Lucas getting distracted by the crowd a little bit there.
So eventually we're going to get our hands back on them, and once we do, we're going to get our hands on our belts.
I believe it, and I'm looking forward to it. Of course, with the Nightmare now being part of that equation, there's going to be some problems on the outside of the rings. How are you guys going to handle that monster?
Well, there's only one way. It's just overcome your nightmares.
Ah, there it is.
Yeah. And he is a massive nightmare.
He is a big boy.
Yes.
We haven't really had any action yet. Looking at Chuck circling around, watching Barry as well he should. Never trust Barry Wolf. And the lockup in the middle.
Chuck's gonna play around with Lucas as he does.
Grab on that beard. Because Lord knows Lucas has grabbed on his enough.
Chuck is obsessed with beards.
I've noticed.
If he can touch one, he'll do it.
Are there any suits, anything against him for touching beards? Can he not go into certain counties?
No suits.
Okay.
Yet.
Good.
I'm sure there's people contesting his actions.
Yep.
As far as beardophilia.
Beardophilia. Yeah. I like that one. Low lockup. Chuck backing him in. Oh, and the reversal.
And as you can see, Lucas also likes to touch the beards.
Yep.
Chuck's had problems with headlocks, and he obviously has a problem seeing where he could have got one.
Absolutely.
So he's been working on it, though. I got to give him that. He's been working on the headlocks.
You guys are always so helpful when he's in the corner. If he's in a headlock, you make sure that you yell out to him, Chuck, you're in a headlock. Yeah. Chuck, you just got thrown down. You're keeping him abreast of the situations, and I'm sure he appreciates that.
It's also to annoy him.
Say, he's sitting there by himself right now. He may not be aware of what is happening.
Oh, yeah, no, no, he'll hear us. Oh,
okay.
Yeah,
he'll figure it out.
He can feel it. He can hear the voices in his head.
Well, he'll physically hear them.
One of those guys with the fillings. He's got a filling, so he gets, like, radio transmissions and stuff.
No, our voices
He's listening carry. To big band music right now, isn't he?
Our voices carry, but he's probably listening to ska. He listens to a lot of ska as you see him, you know, skank around the ring.
A little real big fish, maybe. Yeah.
He likes all those underground bands.
Ones that we've never heard of.
Chuck is a hipster.
Yep, exactly.
He doesn't like radio music.
Now Barry Wolf is involving himself on the outside right now. He could use somebody on the outside on his corner right now.
Yeah. Hold, please. I'm going to take away from the mic. He's got your hat.
Shaky shouting it out right now, and seems like he finally heard it.
Lucas Frost,
and, yeah,
don't let the age fool you. That man is still quick.
But we're the Boot Boys. You can't do that. That's ours.
Right?
That is called gimmick infringement.
Have you copyrighted it? Did you send it to yourself in the mail?
We're going to say we did.
Okay. I believe it. And now that it's on the internet, it's true.
Is your
goal now to get everybody else wearing sandals to wrestle? Like, you've copyrighted the concept of wearing boots?
No, it's just boots.
Okay.
No, that's boots.
Just the using of the boots.
Yeah,
to boot a person.
To boot a person.
The verb.
Putting the boots
You
to
own them. The verb now.
Boots to brains.
Gotcha.
Chuck off the corner. High
As
kick.
I just said, boots to brains.
Yep.
Kicked him in the beard, but I assume that's where he keeps his brain.
Yeah,
that works.
Right here. It is where you would keep your brain.
If you were Lucas Frost.
If you were smart. In the beard. The beard is very protective.
Chuck.
Most of the time it cushions punches to the chin.
Dropping boots on Lucas's soft midsection. Chuck with that quick roll.
He likes dolphin. It's dolphin time.
Dolphin time. And that headbutt that we all love.
Yep. it doesn't look like it gives a lot of impact, but I assure you it hurts. It does.
I have felt his head, don't ask why, and it is quite hard.
What? Wait, no.
No, I told you not to ask.
Nope, you can't.
It does
just,
shaky.
You
shaky.
You can't just glance over that. You can't glance
I had
past
my
that.
Head shaved at the time we were comparing stubble and shaving techniques. That's all I'm going to say.
Slap. He's got Lucas Frost right where he wants him
fifth.
Right now, but he really needs to finish this off.
Fifth.
Every time.
Barry Wolf over to consult a little bit.
Pardon me again. Hold on a sec. I hope he heard me.
Lord, I hope so, too.
It would be wise. It's not a bad idea.
We'll bring a bullhorn next time. You can just shout it from up here.
Oh, yeah. No, then I just keep it on siren the whole time.
Oh, God.
Chuck takes him for the ride. Lucas
Chuck
in the corner.
Lucas dodges that one. DDT right in the middle.
You can't take a break at all with a guy like Lucas Frost.
Absolutely.
He's got the experience, and he is ready to use it at any moment. Pulling him up.
Lucas Frost has an eye for opportunity, that is for sure.
Yep. Well, he's been around the business for quite a while, so you got to figure he's seen a lot of things and been a part of even more.
We've faced off against him plenty of times.
Yep.
Are you saying he was a part of things that he did not see? Is that what you're... Is that what you're suggesting?
I
he
might
was a part
be.
Of things that he did not see?
I might be.
He's seen some things, but he's
I've
been
seen,
a part
I've
of more.
Him. The ref didn't see him, but I've seen him.
If he just keeps his own eyes closed.
I have seen my fair share of the sole of his shoe.
There you go. That's right.
And it wasn't fun.
Cowboy Scott up here also. I don't know that I've ever seen Scott climb stairs.
Me neither.
That's pretty amazing.
Know that could happen.
Who cares? It's probably easier than getting into the ring with the chair and the steps and everything.
Who carried you? Who carried you?
Nobody carried me.
I
floated.
No, I don't believe that. I don't believe that at all.
The enthusiasm. Chuck's in the corner again, and Barry Wolf taking advantage with another chokehold in the corner.
And Barry's got a hold of my brother.
Good
Come
heaven.
On,
Red. Barry
Lucas
will seize
has
any opportunity.
Referee Dave looking in the opposite direction. They're having a conversation. They might break out some tea at any moment.
And see, I told Chuck before he went down that we needed to stay down there with him to keep this stuff from happening.
Absolutely.
He told us, no, I got this. This is all me.
And Chuck sometimes doesn't necessarily think before he says things.
He is hard-headed.
Yep.
As previously discussed.
Yes.
Lucas with
that
drop kick in the corner.
So much.
The takedown rolls him over off the ropes.
But ouch. Like, and because I know Chuck's going to listen to this later, Chuck, kick out. Kick out now.
He's not currently,
yeah, he's not pinned.
Not currently being pinned. But if he projects back, if you roll it back to a second before he said that, that was the perfect time to kick out.
See, as I stated earlier, Chuck has a hard head, so that's the one thing Frost has always made a mistake. He aims for the head, it's just going to end up hurting his hand.
Absolutely, yep.
Referee Dave making an adjustment to one of the turnbuckles there. Lucas Frost taking advantage.
There you go. That's what I'm talking about.
With the roll up.
Ring awareness. That's my boy. Well, I
he may not be aware of much else, but he's aware of the ring.
Yes, it's there. He knows it's there.
And he knows it's square.
Yep.
Contrary to what the name ring would imply.
If he keeps falling down, he might think it's a triangle.
That may be.
You know.
Chuck dragging right now. Lucas seems to be a bit in control. Only a bit, though.
The length of this match starting to get to both men.
Oh, and a rake to the eyes. Come on, Dave.
Lucas
is making his case. It looked like a rake, but we're not down there next to him. He's got the...
That was a thumb to the eye.
Speaking, maybe it was more than one finger to the eye. It was all of the fingers to the eye.
Speaking from experience, that was a thumb to the eye.
You know the way that thumb works.
Yes. Yes, I have.
Barry Wolf taking advantage again. Dave warning again, he's been warning a lot, and there is nothing to follow up any of these warnings.
No.
Lucas taking Chuck for the ride.
Lucas misses that quick elbow.
Come on, buddy.
Chuck doing a little rally.
Come on, buddy.
Sends him off, follows through in a quick miss.
Lucas doesn't hang around
with
for
that
either.
High
come on,
super
come
kick.
On. Come on, buddy. Kick out. Don't let
Chuck
this be
it. Rolled over.
Don't do it.
One, two, and out at two and a half.
That's what I'm talking about. It's a good thing he had his protein and Pop-Tarts before this match. Otherwise, he probably wouldn't have kicked out of that.
Now, as much weight as Chuck and Bubbler have been losing, should Pop-Tarts still be part of the equation?
Absolutely.
All right.
It's part of a winning breakfast.
You know, okay. I'm with you.
We have won multiple championships.
It depends on what exactly you're trying to win.
In this particular case, gold.
Oh,
so like, okay. Don't get me wrong. We may have made a few mistakes and lost the gold, but protein and Pop-Tarts has led to our gold and our success. So get the
Chuck
boots up.
Rallying up onto the top. Holding on to that mouth.
Is it?
Up and back.
Oh, yes. Takes Lucas Frost over.
Very nicely
both
done.
Both men down. Dave begins to count.
I'm going to officially
get
dub
up.
That move called Hurricane Chuck. Hurricane Chuck.
I like it.
There was somebody in Chuck's corner right now. They could let him know that he needs to stand up.
Absolutely. Hold on one second.
Please do.
All right, hold on.
Get up!
There we go.
Is he trying to high-five the referee?
Chuck's a little loopy right now.
He's trying
now.
To tag in the referee right now.
Maybe so.
Would you have
and if
many...
he did, that would be amazing.
It would. It would absolutely. I agree. I think Super Dave sure could.
We've been discussing this for a while. We think Dave's still got some ups in him. He can go.
Ooh. That was,
Chuck with a nasty kick to the chin.
That was great.
Lucas
But his beard softened the blow, I bet.
It did. He may not. It didn't seem like he got all of it. I didn't see that. Did you see that?
I didn't see a thing.
I didn't see that.
Oh, Barry and Lucas having a conversation.
Look at Chuck the
advantage.
Two, and
look at
there's the three right counts.
And that's
Chuck
why we're called
the
Boot Boys.
And rolls out of the ring.
We're called the Boot Boys
right?
Because of the roll-ups. That's
exactly
why we're called.
Right.
All right, guys. I appreciate
Shaky,
it. Thank
it's
you.
A pleasure as always.
Thank you, let me come
thank
on.
Thank you for joining us.
Oh,
we'll see
you. Just to get him to laugh, it's for you, good brother.
There it is.
Chuck makes out with the ring. Bubbler headed
Bubbler
down the ringside right now.
Bubbler's so happy, so jovial.
I think there's still a little bit of disagreement going on between Barry Wolf and Lucas Frost. There was definitely a misconnection there. Barry Wolf with the trip on Lucas Frost.
Right.
It was hard to tell if he was actually trying to save him from a move that Chuck was about to put on, but Lucas seemed to be in charge of the moment.
Yeah,
and,
I'm not
Barry
exactly
just
sure
threw
where.
The arm out there.
I don't know where it broke down, but
now
it
now there's
definitely
some
did.
Shoving going on. Barry and Lucas.
Yikes. If there was one word to describe the night so far, it's pandemonium.
You know, sometimes there's a little bit of disagreement, but even the guys with the dastardly plans need to patch it up every once in a while.
Chuck being carried off like the hero that he is.
Shaky was wanting to win gold, and he might have won him a golden Chuck.
Could be worse things.
I'm not sure what it would be.
I don't know either. And another circuit around about killing a woman.
Chuck's going to get his five high fives even if he can't walk around the
right.
ring.
There we go.
I think Bubbler's just looking for a calf workout.
He'll find it anywhere he can get it.
Anywhere he can get it. So I'm wondering if Chuck has given up Pop-Tarts and he's instead going for protein and roll-ups.
I see what you did there, you dirty bastard.
See
all right.
See what I did. Look at it. Bask in it.
Soak it in, man.
Rub it all over yourself.
Oh, I don't want
like a dirty dog.
Oh, God.
So we're going to take about a 10-minute intermission.
We're coming up to the intermission. Hang tight. We're coming back in just a few moments. Peace.